Okay. Hello, everybody. Welcome to This Week in Seattle live stream. Before we start, as I mentioned before, there's kind of a funny link up problem when I try to broadcast the class onto Facebook. So I'm recording the class, but only myself. So if you get a notification about that, it's just what's being taught. Now that we have that out of the way, welcome to This Week in Seattle live stream. It's Solo Jazz One and our last week of the Shim Sham. Yes, yes. So I thought what might be fun is let's just do the Shim Sham at the very beginning as part of our warm-up. And I'm going to put us on pretty slow, slower than we've been doing, just so we can try to get an ear for it. And let's just give it a shot here. And it might be new for some of us, but that's all right. Let's just do our first two choruses. And here we go. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Up. Double it up. Left foot, right foot. Double it up. Right foot, left foot. Great time. Step, touch, step, touch. it's going to go half break, kick, ball change. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Half break, kick, ball change. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Ida, walk, e. Twice in a row. Okay. 5, 6. Twice in a row. Half break, shoot, da-da. Half break, shoot, da-da. 5, 6. Twice in a row. E-da-wa-ki-di. E-da-wa-ki-di. Excellent. Then we add on our T-O-B-A break, which we know goes step, touch, back, back, front, front. So let's put those pieces together. Two half breaks and then our full break. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. E-da-wa-ki-di. E-da-wa-ki-di. Step, touch, back, back, and there it is. Good, good, good. Let's do that one more time. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Ti-da, ti-da, ee-dee-ee-dee-ah-ah. Shoot, there. Twice in a row, okay. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Half break. Step, touch, back. Do it again, half break. Step, touch, back, there it is. Good, good, yes. Excellent, last time. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Ooh-da, ooh-da, ee-dee, ee-dee. And one more time. Ee-dee, 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 ee-dee. Shoot, shoot, boom, there. Love it. Let's do that piece by itself with the music. And here we go. I think. Five, six, seven, half break.
with you.
Once from the top. Let's do it once with keeping all of the TOBA bricks. So that's the first time we go through it. We keep all of the. So let's take it from the top without the music. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Right foot, left foot. Hoorah, hoorah. Dee 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 dee. Hoo-doo, hoo-doo. Choo-doo, choo-doo. And here's a brick. And you push it and you push it and you cross over and you push it and you push it and you cross over and you push it and you push it and you cross over and you cross over and you tacky and you touch, 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 rock, touch, 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 rock, touch, touch, and here's the break. Step, touch, half back, half break, beady. One more time. Half break. Half break. Shoot. Yes. 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 Now, it's hard for me to tell via the Zoom, but were you breathing at all during that sequence of events? I hope so. I hope so. It's good because here's the thing. The song is longer than you can hold your breath for. So I'm just saying, start that breathing now. That's planning for the future. So let's walk through the second Shim Sham chorus. That means the second time through, as a reminder, we take away all of the full breaks. So for instance, the first section would go, hoorah, hoorah, ah, ah, hoorah, hoorah, ah, ah, hoorah, hoorah, ha, ha, freeze, two, ah, ah, ah. Yeah, yeah? So that TOBA break, we just take it away, you go, oh yeah, let's do it. From the top of the second chorus, all the way through. Hey, ho, here we go. Ooh-rah, ooh-rah, ah, ah, ooh-rah, ooh-rah, ah, ah, ooh-rah, ooh-rah, and here's the freeze. Freeze, shoot, ba-dee-ka, then you go, and you push it, and you push it, and you cross over, and you push it, and you push it, and you cross over, and you push it, and you push it, and you cross over and you cross over and you tacky and you hoop, heep, 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 hoop, heep, 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 hoop, heep, and here's the freeze, shoot, ah, half break, half break, half break, freeze, ooh, ah, half break, half break. What time is it? It's boogie time. Oh yeah, that's what happens after that. How are we doing? Yes, yes, okay. So let's do this much from the top. Let's take it through both choruses. The thing to remember when we use Taint What You Do, which is the song we've been cycling this session, there's actually a little gap, there's a little kind of bridge section in there. So we won't start the second time through immediately. You get to hang for a little bit. So you'll see. Let's take it. With the tune. Twice three. Yeah. Tanya. Tanya.
Things they go, but this one thing you want.
Six, this way, but if there is a caller, they call out, what time is it? And then it's boogie time. And then we start this B section that we talked a little bit about last week. But let's walk through this whole boogie section now. Boogie backs, we know go boop ba da, boop ba da, boop ba da, and boop ba da. But for our purposes here, we're going to give it the real Frankie low down feel. Clap back back, clap back back, clap back back, clap back back. Can you try that some? Can you go clap back back, clap back back, clap back back, clap back back. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Shoot buddy, shoot buddy, shoot buddy, shoot buddy. Excellent, excellent. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Good. So this, if I do this fancy here, it is does feel kind of down some. Yeah, that's maybe good for us. So rather than up here, you might spread the feet out a little bit some. So it's a little more of a squat if you feel comfortable doing so. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Now we get our boogie forward going. So as we recall from last week, it starts with a walk forward with our right. We're going right, left, right, left. That looks like watch once. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Can we try it together? Boogie forward, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Boogie forward, 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 forward. Good, good. Let's do it again. 5, 6, 5, 6. Ooty, 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 ooty. Excellent. So something for those who are feeling comfortable with this boogie forward step, Frankie would oftentimes take his arms and actually kind of frame his hips. See how a little bit here? So he actually kind of drew them back a little bit some here. And so he wasn't as up, it's kind of more back. So good chest opener. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, boogie forward, 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 forward. Which is kind of a fun way to style. So now we should put these two parts together. Boogie back, boogie forward, boogie back, boogie forward. I said, I'll five, a six, seven. Bring it back, bring it back, bring it back, and bring it forward. Boogie forward, forward. One more time, bring it back. Back, 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 forward, forward, forward. Very good. Yes, 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 yes. That is boogie back and boogie forward. Let's just hold on to that for a second because I think we should get to the last step because we keep the same boogie structure where you're going boogie back, but this time you do a very special step called shorty George. Shorty George. So let's take a look at what Shorty George looks like. So put your feet hilariously close together. Well, that's close. And then you let your knees relax a little bit. Now, step forward with your left foot. Then a little bit with your right. And a little bit with your left. And the smallest step with your right. And then with your left. And then your right. And then your left. Good. So the trick is, and if I face you here, I want to try to close the gap between my knees and keep them together. So if you want to take an invisible string and just kind of tie that, tie those knees together, good. Exhale, that's good, that's good. So now that you've got that feeling, see a very narrow line in front of you. And if you can, if you look at my feet, I try to keep my feet in one line. So I'm not doing this, which is turning my feet. Instead, I want to keep them really close together. All right. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's what we want. That's good. Ah, yeah, there it is. Okay, so try that a few times on your own. One of the things you might notice now when you're doing this, it might feel like you're walking a little bit on the outside of your shoe. Exciting. Yeah, that's good. That's good. So let's do this much now. We're going to go step, 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 step. Can we try it together? Let's go. Step, 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 step. Excellent. One more time. Hey, ho, here we go. Step, 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 step. Now, it goes without saying that this is not the world's most comfortable step. No. What makes it kind of fun is because it looks very different and it has kind of a more of an eccentric feel. One of the things that maybe gives it an even more accentuated feel, tie that string around your knees again and hold both ends of the rope and just pull it to one side and then the other. Try that. Oh yeah, that's what we want. Pull those knees across. Oh yeah, there it is. Good, now if you can, try to do it, but keep your shoulders in the same place. So I'm not doing this, it's this. So it's all happening kind of, oh yeah, that looks real freaky. That's good, okay, go ahead and relax. So now watch once, if I do this at you, see how I pull the string with my hands? And you get this thing that feels a little bit slinky. Yes, ooh, slinky, let's look at it again. Step, 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 step. Can we try it together? Hey, ho, here we go. Step, 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 step. Oh yeah, let's go. Let's do it one last time. Hey, ho, here we go. Shoot, 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 shoot. Awesome. A little side note here. So one of the people that kind of trained me a little bit on this step, who learned it directly from Frankie, and Frankie said that he was one of the only people he'd seen who kind of had a sense of how the step was really supposed to look. If you took a piece of paper and put it between your knees, you should be able to hold the paper there. So you should have that much kind of friction between your knees, versus in here, the paper would drop, right? But if I keep it really close, then you get something like this. How fun. Let's try it. Hey, ho, keep the paper. Step, 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 step. There it is. Awesome. Now let's take a look at how this step starts. Earlier we went kick, step, step. You know that. Kick, step, step. We did that on the half break. Let's do it. Kick, step, step. Now do it and travel forward. Kick, step, step. Travel forward. Kick, step, step. Kick, step, step. Yes? Excellent. So you notice when you land, kick, step, step, your weight is on your left foot. Let's do that. 8 and 1, 5, 6, 7. 8 and 1, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1. Good, now, Shorty George. It looks like this, Shorty George. Look at that again. Shorty George. Can we try it together? 5, 6. 5, 6, 7. Shorty George. 5, 6. 5, 6, 7. Shorty George. Good, good, good. So now that's how it starts. It looks like this. I'll do it at you. Shorty George, 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 George. There it is. Let's try it. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Shorty step, 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 step. Amazing. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Shorty George, George, George. And there you go. Good. Go back, go back, go back, go back. Shorty George, 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 George. Let's try it. Boogie back into Shorty George. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Boogie back, boogie back, boogie back. And Shorty George, Shorty George, George, George. And do it again. Boogie back, boogie back, boogie back. And Shorty George, Shorty George, George, George. And that's the end. Yes. One more time. More. I know. You're like, wait, that's it? Yeah, that's it. Let's do it one more time. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Bring it back, bring it back, bring it back, bring it back. Shorty George, George, George. And one more time. Back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up. Shorty George, George, George. And there you go. Good, good. Whew. Let's think about putting this whole boogie session together. So, boogie back, boogie forward. Again, boogie back, boogie forward. Boogie back, Shorty George. Boogie back, Shorty George. Let's do it. Here we go. I said a 5, a 6, a 5, 6, 7. Bring it back, bring it back, bring it back. And boogie forward, 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 forward. Bring it back, bring it back, bring it back, bring it back. And bring it forward, forward. Bring it back, back it up, back it up, back it up. Shorty George, Shorty George, George, George. One more time. Back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up. Shorty George, George, George. And there it is. Success? Success. Let's try this much boogie section with the music. Shorty George, Shorty George, 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 George. I step open here at the end so that I'm ready to do boogie back. I think what's tricky is if you're here and then you suddenly have to open the feet up. But again, Shorty George, 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 and stepping out, back it up. Now that maybe gives you a better base for that next set of boogie backs. Last time, and then we missed it all.
Then you got to swing. Oh, hey, what you do? It's the place that you do. Hey, what you do? It's the place that you do. Hey, what you do? It's the place that you do. With that one, yes.
Bring it back up. Hydrate for a second. That's probably a wise choice, all this moving around. Cool. Very good. While you're doing that, I'm going to mention something that I mentioned in the last class. Are you catching your breath? Which is tomorrow is Frankie Manning's birthday. It is the Lindy Hoppers. We celebrate it all around the world. But it is also being celebrated tomorrow on the Google homepage. So there is going to be a Savoy Ballroom themed graphic celebrating Frankie Maddux's birthday and the wonderful, important history of the Savoy Ballroom. So make sure you check it out tomorrow. I'll send a link out in the information around the background of how that graphic came about, but you know where to find it. Okay, are we ready? From the top, we're ready to do the Shim Jam, both choruses, once through with the breaks, second time through with the freezes, then we add the boogie section. Sound good? Let's do it from the top. Show this video that I was trying to show in the first week, and Frankie's talked a bit about the Shim Sham. It was recorded actually in the late 1980s, the commentary portion, but then it shows some video of Frankie doing the Shim Sham, and that material is maybe from the early 90s. One of the years, 1993, Ballard. Yes, so it was recorded over in Ballard, and I think maybe some of us might have been there. So go ahead and take a step in if you like. Let's take a look at this section. It's about 5 minutes long or so, but I think it's worth giving a look to. Oh, not this one. Not this one. This one.
It starts out very simple. As a matter of fact, it goes through very simple. You start out on your right foot, put it forward, bring it back. Left foot, put it forward, bring it back. Did y'all do that?
Oh, that's you. We know what to do.
Step in the groove, you know.
program was originated by a fellow, I think, name was Leonard Reed, who lives right here in California. I think maybe some of you have heard of him. It was put together by, you know, a lot of different people, and a lot of them was chorus girls and all like that. So they would just get everybody up on the stage, and they would do the Shim Sham. And if you've ever seen any movies of Fred Astaire, Ginger Rogers, Gene Kelly, any of them, they have, you have seen some steps of the Shim Sham done by them. I think Gene Kelly did a whole lot, did a whole chorus of Shim Sham and American from Paris. If you remember the scene where he was with the little kids on the sidewalk, and he did a whole chorus of the Shim Sham. Ginger Rogers and Fred Astaire did it in Flying Down to Rio. They did Shim Sham in that movie. So Shim Sham is very popular, and it has gotten popular lately. And what I would like to do is teach it to you so that you can say, well, I'm not a movie star, but I can do Shim Sham. Be standing, you'd be going to a party, you know, and music be playing, and you can get up there. Somebody say, what you doing, man? Shim Sham, Shim Sham, what's the matter? You don't know how to do Shim Sham?
This is a taxi. Step in the Shim Sham is called a tacky ann. And that came from a showgirl that her name was Ann, and she was a little, do I have to say it? So they actually named that step after her and called it the tacky ann. So, so that's how the steps were originated. Seen any tap dancers at any time or another, you will find at least one step from the Shim Sham Shimmy that they are doing. So it's a, you know, a combination of a lot of steps. The phrase is only four original steps in the Shim Sham Shimmy. Four. So, I mean, 10 minutes, you'll be able to dance that, right?
Four.
Yeah.
Dance, it's all coming to you. Says things may come, things may go. This one thing you ought to know.
Not very much history, right? I mean, it goes back a long way because Shim Sham is actually one of the oldest jazz dances that was originated, which goes way back to like 1932. And somebody else said, 1932, wow. When was that? Well, I tell you that because I happen to be there. I can go back that far, right?
All right. So, Shim Sham history from Frankie there for you. Okay, are we ready? Can we do it one last time? Here we go. Let's put it together from the top. Thanks, Frankie. Hey, 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 hey The boogie section for today real quick. And then when we do it one last time, we're actually going to do it this way. So when Frankie would come to town, he would lead the shim sham, kind of the way that maybe I've been doing it in this class with you, where he would call out the steps and then everybody in the room would stand up and you would just feel the whole place shaking as we're stomping off and doing the shim sham together. So this last time we do it through, we're actually gonna use a recording of Frankie calling the shim sham. It was recorded at his birthday party at the Roseland Ballroom. And we talked a little bit about the Roseland and the Charleston class the other week. But here we go. Let's have a quick breakdown of the boogie section. So if you want to record your screens, boop, the boogie section, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, back it up, back it up, back it up, and go with me forward, 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 forward. Forward, bring it back, bring it back, bring it back. We do it again, boo-da, boo-da, and then shorty George. Back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up. Shorty George, 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 and one more time. Back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up. Shoot-a-dee-dee-dee, and there it is. Ding. All right, all right. Last time, big finish.
We're going to have Johnny G swinging band play the shim sham. A one, two, a
here
one,
we go. I started to really hear for a second. I got too excited. One second.
We're going to have John G. Swing band.
Wait for the first phrase of that. Yeah.
Shim shim. A one, two, a one, two, three, four.
All right.
One more time.
Thank you for today. Thank you for this whole session. So we're going to do something a little bit different in this time slot for live stream classes in June. It's still going to be solo, but it is going to be a bit of a solo jazz sampler. And by that, we might do some different kind of solo dance steps. They'll all still be, you know, classic jazz kinds of steps, but we're not going to be maybe doing the same kind of fall off the log, tacky Annie, half break, some of the stuff that we've done before. We maybe get to experiment a little bit. Maybe we see some old era dances, maybe pre-swing dances. Maybe we look at a little bit of shag. Maybe we recreate a fun little routine, something different. But that's gonna be really fun. So we encourage you to check that out. It's gonna be kind of an all levels experience. I think it's really gonna be fun and maybe is a neat way to get exposed to a wider breadth of this kind of jazz vocabulary and history. All right. Thank you very much for today again. You all have a wonderful night. You're amazing. See you next time. Awesome.